I'm here with Nilesh, who is the CEO and founder of Calamus, which is the world's safest e-bike. So thanks for chatting with us. It'd be great if you could tell me about the inspiration and the need for this product.
Sure, thank you for having us. So this is the world's safest e-bike, and when we started out, we wanted to create the bike with the right features and the right overarching vision. And the idea here was to address major issues while riding e-bikes. Safety, theft, design and user experience. So these are pillars of inspiration for the bike, and we've focused a lot on these so that you feel safer on the road, you feel sexier on the road, and you enjoy riding as much as you do every single day. So one of the prominent features that makes us the safest e-bike is the blind spot assist system.
Okay.
So what that does is, it say you're riding on the road and there's oncoming traffic from behind, and you're trying to change the lane or you're trying to take a turn and you can't see what's behind you. So the bike will detect it for you, and it will give you a haptic feedback on the handlebar.
Okay.
So there's a vibration so that it warns you that you should not take the turn at this moment. Then we have the 360 degree lighting system, which also double up as turn indicators and brake lights. And then there is the onboard navigation, which is touchscreen enabled. So you don't have to have your phone outside. Everything is integrated into the bike, and we focus a lot on design also. So you can see the unibody frame, and you can see clean lines everywhere. That's what we focus on.
So can you talk to me a bit more in depth about the technology that's used? You were telling me about the blind spot assist and also the haptic feedback. Can you just talk us through the technological side of this?
Sure. So the blind spot assist system works using automotive grade LiDAR sensors. So these detect up to 20 meters of distance behind you, and these are acceleration, speed and distance based. So we're detecting multiple parameters at the same time. And of course, this right now, we've not reached the stage in terms of accuracy that we want to. That will require a lot of testing. Since we've recently launched the bike, this will take at least a year to go up to 90-95% is what we want. In terms of the communication and in terms of the electronics that we use, these are all in-house developed, and the software too. So these are for iOS and Android, and we are trying to use Canvas system for our entire bike, and this system basically is also automotive grade, and very, very few e-bike companies in the world are using this system, and we want to focus and take the industry forward when it comes to the protocol. Yeah.
And what are you hoping to achieve by the end of CES?
Potential customers, good interest from investors also, and the exposure. I think the exposure is very important for us. US is a very prominent market. We've seen a lot of interest from here. And people from all over the world are here. And just the opportunity to come here and show our creation to the world means a lot to us.
Well, congratulations on your launch and exhibiting here at CES, and thanks for speaking with us.
Thank you so much.